For those who ask, why do the Shi'a visit the shrine of Imam Hussain alayhi salam? For the lovers of Imam Hussain alayhi salam, nothing makes them happier than to be in his holy shrine, which is why every year millions of people flock towards the holy city of Karbala, especially on the days of Ashura and Arbaeen. It was the Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam themselves, alongside the righteous companion of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi, Jabir ibn Abdullah al-Ansari, who were the first to perform the pilgrimage of the Imam on the 20th of Safar, exactly 40 days since the massacre of Karbala, hence why it is referred to as Arba'een. In the days leading up to Arba'een, it is not uncommon to see people walking from Najaf to Karbala, emulating how the Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam walked to the Imam after their ordeals in Damascus. In fact, some people even walk as far as from Basra in the south of Iraq and even from the Iranian border just to get to Karbala. The rewards and benefits of visiting the shrine of Imam Hussain alayhi salam in Karbala are so numerous that whole books have been written on this topic. Amongst these narrations, there is a dua that was recited by Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam. O Allah, forgive me and my brothers and sisters, those who go on ziyarah to my father Hussain alayhi salam, spending their wealth to travel, seeking to please us and hoping for the reward you have prepared for them. They go on ziyarah to make your messenger sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi happy, and our enemies have criticized them for going. So have mercy on those faces which have been burnt by the sun, and have mercy on those cheeks that have been rubbed themselves on the grave of Imam Hussain alayhi salam. Have mercy on those eyes that have shed tears for us in sympathy, and have mercy on those hearts which have become restless and anguished for us, and have mercy on those screams for us. O Allah, I entrust them to you until the day of great thirst, when you will quench the thirst with the pool of Kawthar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala include us amongst the visitors of Imam Hussain alayhi salam, and those for whom the Holy Prophet, Lady Fatima, and the Imams of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam pray for.